present to you my screen here. Okay, can you see my screen now? Yes or no, girls?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So what are we going to do? We are going to read this test. First, you are going to read it alone. Then we are going to read it together, and you're going to ask me about unknown vocabulary. And after that, we are going to answer the questions, okay? Here. And these ones. Okay, girls. Hola, Erika, ¿cómo estás? How are you? Para Erika y me parece que Daniela, que no escucharon cuando dije, en el chat les voy a dejar el formulario de la asistencia, ¿ok? Entonces ya se los voy a enviar para que lo llenen, por favor. Thank you. So, let's continue. So I'm going to give you guys 10 minutes. Do you think that 10 minutes is enough or it's too much for reading this test? What do you think? Enough or too much? 10 minutos, ¿qué creen para leer este texto? ¿Muy poquito o mucho?
I think it's too much.
Too much? Okay, let's say 5 minutes, 5.
All right.
Okay, so let's do it. At 4:14, I'm going to ask you. Then we're going to read it together, okay? Entonces, a las 4:14, lo volvemos a leer juntas, okay? So, there you go. Hello, Rocío. Rocío, we are doing a reading exercise.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon. Rocío, estamos haciendo un ejercicio de lectura. Entonces, si quieres, puedes comenzar a leer el texto que está ahí. Y ahorita, a las 4:14, lo leemos juntas y me preguntan todo sobre vocabulario, ¿vale?
Yes, teacher. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, guys, how you doing? Did you finish?
No, teacher.
Okay. Let me know when you're ready.
Dance.
Miguel, we are doing a reading exercise, okay? So we are reading that test, and after that, we're going to read it together.
Okay, teacher. Muchas gracias.
You're welcome. Okay, you ready, girls and Miguel? ¿Cómo vamos, chicas? ¿Ya terminamos?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So let's read it together, and you are going to ask me anything that you don't know, okay? So let's do it. It says, last summer, Joel and Sarah traveled to England for 2 weeks. They traveled in August and stayed in a college with other students in Brighton. Do you know what is a college?
¿Colegio?
Ajá. Es algo así como la universidad. Hagan de cuenta como un técnico. Okay?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So, which other students in Brighton? The south of England. It was really fantastic because they talk a lot. They talk to a lot of students of different nationalities and learn a lot about other cultures and customs. Do you know what is customs?
Costumbres?
Yes, perfect. Of course, they learn a lot of English too because they practice it every day. In the morning, they studied a little. They asked the teacher to speak slowly when necessary and answered her questions. Do you know what he says slowly?
Lento.
Despacio o lento. Perfect. In the afternoon, they visit different places or play different sports at the college. It was so much fun. Do you know what is fun?
Divertido. Yeah.
Perfect. They often walk down to the beach with their new friends and played or chatted. Do you know what is chatted?
Charlando. Chatear, hablar.
Perfect. In the evening, they were tired, so they sometimes watch videos or play board games. Do you know what is board games?
Juegos de video.
Como juegos de mesa. Como, por ejemplo, escaleras, ¿cierto? Parques, like that. The best days were Saturday and Sunday because they traveled to London. The city is very big and they visited all the monuments like Big Ben, the London Eye, and Buckingham Palace. They wanted to see the Queen, but they didn't see her, only her wards. Do you know what is wards?
Celadores, guardias.
Ajá, los guardias, los de seguridad. They liked everything in the city, but their favorite thing was the museums, especially Madame Tussauds. There were lots of realistic figures of famous people there. At the end of the 2 weeks, they were sad to return home. The holidays were fun and different from usual. They cried a little when they waved. Do you know what is waved? ¿Saben qué es wave?
No, teacher. No, wave teacher.
Es como la acción que uno hace cuando dice chao con la mano, que la mueve hacia un lado y hacia el otro. La palma de la mano, ¿sí? Cuando uno dice adiós. Eso es wave, ¿ok? Mover la mano hacia un lado y hacia el otro, ¿ok?
Ok, teacher.
El wave de esperar.
So, ¿cómo?
O sea, no cómo se escribe, sino cómo se escucha el wait. Wait for me. O sea, el wait de esperar.
No, es diferente. Este wave es como si fuera con F. Con F.
Sí, pero suena igual en la pronunciación.
Bueno, en pasado suena con D, waved. Y el otro es waited, or wait. Okay. Ajá. So they waved goodbye to their new friends and promised to write or send emails when they arrived home. So perfect. What we're going to do now? We are going to write the past simple of these verbs, but paying attention to the spelling rules, okay? So what's the past simple of travel?
Teacher?
Yes.
Una preguntita. Este usual cuando dice the holidays were fun en diferentes.
Ajá.
¿Cómo? Ahí cómo lo interpreto, cómo lo utilizo ese usual ahí.
Okay, ese usual es como decir las vacaciones fueron divertidas, diferentes de lo que ellos hacen usualmente, o sea, diferente de lo que era su rutina. ¿Ya? Entonces ahí hacen la comparación como de la vida diaria de ellos y lo que pasó en esas vacaciones, que fue totalmente diferente a su vida diaria, a lo usual, a lo que están acostumbrados. ¿Ok?
Gracias.
Perfect. De nada. So let's continue. What's the past simple of travel? ¿Cómo es el pasado simple de viajar?
Travel. Travel.
Perfect. Traveled. Traveled. Okay, perfect. What about copy?
Copy it.
Uh-huh. Copy it. What about count?
Counted.
Uh-huh. Counted. What about play?
Play.
Uh-huh. Played. What about clothes?
Closed.
Uh-huh. Closed. What about open?
Opened.
Perfect. Opened. What about dance?
Dance.
Dance. Dance. Con el final, dance. What about drop?
Drop.
Dropped. Perfect. Aquí se le dobla la P porque es un verbo de una sola sílaba. Drop. Dropped. What about cook? ¿Cómo queda cook?
Cooked.
Ajá.
Cooked. Cook.
Ajá. La E no suena, entonces es como con T. Cooked. ¿Ok? What about leaf? Lived. Perfect. What about look?
Look.
Ajá, como una T al final. Looked. Perfect. So now we are going to answer these. We're going to put if these statements are true or false. Okay. Entonces vamos a decir si estas oraciones son verdaderas o falsas. Si son falsas, las vamos a corregir. ¿Ok?
Ok, teacher.
So, the first one, it says, Joel and Sarah traveled to England for 3 weeks. This is true or false?
False.
False.
False. Vamos a concretar en el reading. ¿En dónde dice que sería false? ¿En qué línea?
¿En la primera?
Ajá. Dice, last summer, Joel and Sarah traveled to England for 2 weeks. So perfect. This is false. So how can we make it true? ¿Cómo la podemos volver verdadera? ¿Qué hay que cambiar? ¿Qué hay que cambiar de la primera?
Three.
Ajá, 3, 4, 2, right? Perfect. So Joel and Sarah traveled to England for 2 weeks. Very good. The next one, it says, they stayed in a college. This is true or false?
True.
So let's see. Where it says that they stayed in a college? ¿En qué línea dice que se quedaron en un college?
Second.
In the second, perfect. Here. They stayed in a college, so perfect. It is true. What about this one? Brighton is in the north of England. True or false?
False.
So where is the evidence? Which line?
Third.
The third. Perfect. It says the south of England. Brighton, the south of England. So perfect. So here it goes. It's in the south. Not in the north. Oh. Perfect. What about the next one? It says, they ask the teacher to speak fast. True or false?
False.
So what is the evidence?
Era 1, 3, 6 Lynn.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Speak slowly. Yes, spread fit, not fast, slowly. So perfect. Here was slowly. Not fast. What about the next one? It says, they sometimes walk to the beach. True or false?
True.
True. So what is the evidence?
False. Nine. Line nine. Uh-huh.
Perfect. They often walk down to the beach. Perfect. So now what we're going to do, we're going to write the following sentences, these ones, in the negative and interrogative form of the past simple. So we're going to change it. So the first one, it says, there were many people on the beach. How can I make it negative?
Didn't.
Remember, here they are using were. Este es el pasado simple del verbo to be. ¿Cómo sería la negación? Weren't, right? Weren't. So there weren't many people on the beach. How can I make it interrogative? No escucho. ¿Puedes hablar un poquito más fuerte? En vez de did es where, ¿ok? Porque están hablando, el verbo to be en pasado se conjuga diferente a los demás verbos normales, ¿ok? Entonces, por ejemplo, para negar utilizamos wasn't or weren't, y para hacer preguntas, si son con los singulares, was, y si son con plurales, were, ¿ok? So here is where there were there many people
on the beach.
Uh-huh, perfect. This one. He enjoyed the trip. Rocio, how can I make it negative?
He didn't enjoy the trip.
Perfect. He didn't enjoy the trip. Joka, how can I make it interrogative? Or Angela, how can I make it interrogative?
Did he enjoy the trip?
Sus lady, how can I make it this one negative?
He was in London, but no sé el negativo ahí.
Okay. El negativo puede ser she was not or she wasn't, okay?
She wasn't in London.
She wasn't in London. How can I make it interrogative, Erica? Was she in London? Perfect. This one, it says, they stayed in a college. So, lady, how can I make it negative?
They didn't stay in the college.
Perfect. They didn't stay in the college. Now, how can I make it interrogative, Rocío?
Did they stay in the college?
Perfect. So now what we are going to do, we're going to answer the following questions. So it says, what did Joel and Sarah do in the afternoon? Podemos volver al texto si lo necesitan, ¿ok?
Yes, teacher.
¿Volvemos? Ok.
Please.
Okay, ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So, what did Joel and Sarah do in the afternoon?
They visited,
right?
Different place.
Different places. Okay, they visited different places and played.
Oh, se me perdió.
Subimos de nuevo.
No, different place or played and play.
Ajá.
Different sports at the college.
Perfect. So they visited different places or played sports.
Yeah.
At the college. Perfect. The second one, did they learn a lot of new things? Did they learn a lot of things? New things? What do you think? Yes or no? Yes? Or no? Daniela, what do you think? Daniela no participó en la anterior. Dani, are you there? Okay, go ahead, Rocío, or any volunteer. Did they learn a lot of new things? What do you think, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. ¿Y cómo sería la respuesta completa? Yes.
They learn.
Yes, they did, right? Yes, they did. Perfect. So where is the evidence? ¿Dónde está la evidencia de eso?
For la línea cuarta, cuarta uh-huh. línea.
Perfect. Here we have. And learn
a lot for about
the cultures and customs. Okay. Perfect. So now this one, what did they like the best? ¿Qué les gustó más? ¿Recuerdan o subimos al texto? Sus lady, no te escucho. ¿Puedes hablar un poquito más fuerte?
Sube para revisar el texto.
Ok. Ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So, what did they like the best?
The Saturday on Sunday?
Their favorite dates. And
en pasado, ¿cierto?
Ajá.
Entonces,
they liked
the Saturday on Sunday.
Pero esos son como los días favoritos, pero ¿qué actividad les gustaba a ellos? ¿O qué fue lo que más les gustó de
Londres? Ir a Londres a mirar, a ver el Big Ben y a ir al Palacio de la... A ir a Londres a visitar el Palacio de la... y a ver la Reina y el Big Ben, ir a la ciudad.
Entonces miremos, por acá. The best
days... a Londres. The travel to Londres.
Because they travel to London. The city is very big. They visit all the monuments like Big Ben, the London Eye, and Buckingham Palace. They wanted to see the Queen, but they didn't see her, only her words. They like everything in the city, but their favorite thing was the museums, especially Madame Tussauds. So this one. The museum, so, lo que más les gustó a ellos fueron los museos, ¿ok? Eso fue las cosas, su cosa favorita, los museos. So, they liked the museums.
Okay, teacher.
Especially, por acá... De Madame Tussauds. De Madame, ¿cómo se escribe? Tussauds. Doble S. Okay, perfect. The next one, it says, what did they visit in the capital? ¿Qué visitaron en la capital? Es decir, en Londres.
The monuments like Big Ben.
Uh-huh. So they visited all the monuments like Big Ben, the London Eye, Buckingham Palace, right? Perfect.
Estoy confundida para responder, teacher, ¿sabes?
¿Por qué? Dime.
Porque no sé cómo responder.
Ok, mira. Sus Lady, ¿tú estuviste en la clase cuando vimos las tres formas del pasado simple?
Estuve en la clase pasada.
O sea, tú estás conmigo desde la clase pasada.
Sí, señora.
Ah, ok. Claro, debe estar súper perdida entonces. Te voy a explicar, mira. En el pasado simple hay, como todos los tiempos verbales, tiene tres formas. La forma afirmativa, ¿cierto? Que es en la que el verbo es el que cambia, como esta. Esta es la forma afirmativa. El verbo es el que cambia de forma para estar en pasado. Luego tenemos la forma interrogativa, que es esta. En esta forma, el verbo, como puedes ver, el verbo principal no cambia. Él no le pasa absolutamente nada. No tiene ninguna modificación. El que cambia es el verbo auxiliar, que sería aquí do, que pasaría a ser en pasado did. ¿Ok? Lo mismo en la negación. Acá. En la negación, el verbo principal, este que está aquí, no cambia para nada. Él queda igual en infinitivo. El que cambia es el auxiliar, que es do, pero él cambia a pasado, que se convierte en did. Y como es una negación, es didn't. ¿Ok? Esas son las tres formas. Luego tenemos por acá el verbo to be, que este ya lo vimos, pero este lo vimos hace tiempito ya. Y también se conjuga de tres maneras diferentes, ¿ok? Tiene su forma interrogativa, como es la que está aquí, que primero va el auxiliar del verbo to be en pasado, luego el sujeto y luego el complemento. Tiene su forma negativa, que está aquí, ¿cierto? Que primero va sujeto, luego el verbo to be más la negación, que sería was not or wasn't, y luego el complemento. Y por último tiene su forma afirmativa, que sería el sujeto con el verbo to be en pasado normal, negación, y el complemento. ¿Ok?
Afirmativa y negativa, siempre va el sujeto primero.
Ajá, lo que es afirmativa y negativa, ¿dónde está? Esta es negativa. Y afirmativa, estas dos, siempre va el sujeto, luego va el verbo to be, ya sea si es afirmativa sin negación, si es negativa con negación. Y por último, ya el complemento. Y en la interrogativa, el sujeto y el auxiliar cambian de posición. ¿Ok?
Ok. Va primero el auxiliar.
Ajá. Lo mismo con las del presente simple normal. Pasa lo mismo. Entonces, mira acá. Lo que es afirmación, bueno, este es un poco más diferente porque en la afirmación tiene el verbo pero solito, no necesita de ningún auxiliar, ¿cierto? Luego ya viene la negación que sí necesita auxiliar, que sería didn't. Y luego ya viene en pregunta que también necesita auxiliar, que sería did. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Perfect.
Thank you.
So here we have it. What did they visit in the capital? They visited all the monuments like Big Ben, the London Eye, Buckingham Palace. Perfect. The next one, it says, did they like the museums? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, they did. Perfect. Sus lady, otra cosita. Cuando hagan preguntas con did, siempre se debe responder con did, ¿ok? Si hacen preguntas con was, siempre se debe responder con was, ¿ok? Perfect. This one. What museum did they like the best? ¿Qué museo les gustó más?
Okay.
¿Qué museo les gustó más, chicas?
Madame Tussaud.
Ajá. Perfect. De Madame Tussaud. Aquí sería Daylight the best. De Madame Tussaud Museum. Perfect. This one. Did they see the queen? ¿Ellos vieron a la reina? Yes or no?
No.
Yes.
Yes or no? Let's see. No. Yes. Ok, miremos acá. Muéstrenme la evidencia si sí o si no. ¿En qué línea? ¿O en qué párrafo? Primero, segundo, tercero, cuarto. In the second paragraph, right? Here we have. They wanted to see the queen, but they didn't see her, only her words. Entonces, ¿la vieron o no la vieron?
No.
No.
So perfect. Here. Did they see the queen? No, they what? ¿Cómo sería la respuesta completa ahí? No, they
didn't.
Perfect. No, they didn't. The next one, it says, were they happy at the end of the holidays? Explain. So, what do you think? ¿Subimos el texto o se acuerdan?
They sad.
No, they were sad, right? So, where they
okay, where?
Of the holidays, no, right? This is a yes, no question. So the answer is, ¿cuál es la respuesta a esta yes, no question? Yes or no?
No.
No. No, they were not. They weren't.
No, they weren't. They were, right? No, they weren't. They were. They were sad. Ellos estaban tristes. Pero ahí dice que explique. Entonces, ¿por qué estaban tristes? Why were they sad? Let's see here.
Because.
Uh-huh. Because.
¿Puedo subirlo? Ya. Yeah.
Yes.
Goodbye today. They, I feel.
Okay.
Today,
so they were sad to return home.
To return home. Home.
Uh-huh.
Ah, okay.
Yes. They were sad to return home. Perfect. And the last one, it says, what did they promise to do when they arrived home? ¿Qué prometieron ellos hacer cuando llegaron a casa?
To write.
Uh-huh. So they, ay, ¿dónde está escribiendo esto?
Email.
They
arrived home.
Okay, they promised, right? They promised to write and to send
emails.
When?
When they arrive home.
When they arrive home. Okay, aquí no se ve. Voy a correr esto un poquitico. Aquí. Okay, perfect, girls. You did it so good. So do you have any question here? Everything was clear? Yes or no, girls?
For me, no, teacher. I think...
No, teacher, no question.
Okay, perfect. So this is the end of our class. See you on Tuesday, right? Porque nos vemos el martes porque el lunes es festivo en Colombia, okay?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, see you on Tuesday, girls. Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher. Thank you very much.
Happy weekend to you, too.
Thank you. And this blessing.
Thank you.